I'm Evangelist Gabriel Fernandez, and God has called and commissioned me to preach the good news of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. My dear friend, I encourage you as I share a message with you, and I pray for you today. Be in agreement. Connect in faith. Believe, and you shall receive in the name of Jesus. Hello, and welcome to this special video brought to you by GFM United Prayer and Revival Ministry Studios. Our God is good and is gracious. He is our Lord and is with us. Jesus has made a way for us, and through Him we can be reconciled back to the Father. That is the best news if you ask me, and I know, I trust, I believe, wherever you are, as you put your trust in Jesus, He will never let you down. He will never leave you alone, and He always has your back. You can trust in Jesus, and He will see you through in whatever situation, in whatever trial comes your way. Jesus will see you through. My dear friend, I want to speak to you about something very important, and the title of my message today is Enjoy Life. Enjoy the journey and the process. Now, as we begin, let's just welcome the Holy Spirit. Say this out loud with me. Say, Holy Spirit of God, I welcome you. Come, Lord Holy Spirit, and take over control. Help me to pray. Help me to press in. Help me to receive from the Father today. Touch me and take me deeper. Help me to live this life in the way that gives Jesus glory. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, my dear friend, the Bible says in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 1 from verse 13 to verse 14, it says, I applied my heart to seek and to search out by wisdom all that is done under heaven. It is an unhappy business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. I have seen everything that is done under the sun, and behold, all is vanity, a striving after the wind. I'll read that to you one more time. It says, And I applied my heart to seek and to search out by wisdom all that is done under the heaven. It is an unhappy business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. I have seen everything that is done under the sun, and behold, all is vanity and a striving after the wind. Now, my dear friend, the first thing that I want to say to you is let go and live. You know, there are many things that we pursue on a daily basis. There are dreams, aspirations, things that we want to achieve. There are certain things that we do on a daily basis. And my message to you today is don't allow those things to take up your whole life to a point where ultimately you miss out on the blessings that God has given you. Some blessings manifest in different ways. Not all blessings are monetary blessings. Not all blessings are physical blessings. But the blessings of God manifest in different ways. And I'll explain even as we go on. Now, I want to break this down for you. It says, And I applied my heart to seek and search out by wisdom all that is done under heaven. It is an unhappy business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. I have seen everything that is under the sun, and behold, all is vanity, a striving after the wind. Now, notice over here it says, It is an unhappy business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. This is one thing we note. You know, people out there may push on and have success, but for some reason, they don't attain happiness. People may go out and buy all that they want to buy. They may buy many houses, many cars, many different things, but for some reason, they don't find that happiness. And the reason is, those things don't fulfill as the blessings that God has given us. They don't fulfill and they don't satisfy. Only God can quench that inner thirst. But there are other things also, blessings, that are not quantified in terms of material wealth, but they are blessings that God has given us that can give us pure joy and happiness on the inside, and they can give us the sense of security that we need sometimes to press on. Now, some of these things are the gift of life, for instance, a gift to live on every day, to press on and to make our mark, to make an impact in the realm that we're placed in. The gift of family. Family is so precious. You know, in times when everyone else has left you, family will most probably be around. But even then, when family leaves you and everyone else, God will still be around. That in itself is a blessing, and it's something that we should appreciate. But if we get too busy chasing after various different things, we will never appreciate that true blessing. Furthermore, the gift of friends, it's a blessing to have genuine and good friends around you. Is something that you should be thankful for to the Lord. It is a blessing from God, and it contributes to our overall happiness. Many people are unhappy because they've forgotten the core and the basics. They've forgotten these blessings that God has given that are not necessarily quantified in terms of material wealth. Apply the law of grace when dealing with others, because we all fall short and we make mistakes. Don't get upset and don't block them out when they make mistakes. Follow in the footsteps of Jesus. Forgive and love them. When I say apply the law of grace, I mean when God looks at us, He looks at us through the eyes of grace. On a daily basis, we make so many mistakes. We do so many things that could upset Him, but ultimately He has grace and mercy towards us, and this preserves us. In the same way, we are not perfect. We'll have friends who come around us who make mistakes, who make us upset, and ultimately we should look at them through the eyes of grace. Now, a point that I need to stress over here, I've already touched on it, but I want to stress on it again, is don't live your whole life striving after vanity and miss the essence of life in the process. Don't live your whole life pushing after things that don't matter as much and miss those things that matter. You know, the time that we're given with other people is a gift. The time that we are given to live is a gift. The time that we are given to live with God and enjoy His presence is a gift. Enjoy that gift to the fullest. Aim for inner satisfaction and fulfillment as you progress in your journey in life, so that when you are older, you will not feel like you missed out, but rather you will feel a sense of fulfillment. I have heard so many people talk about it. They grow old, they press on chasing after various different things, and ultimately when they're older, they look back and they regret that they didn't live and do certain things that they wanted to do. They look back and they regret that they didn't spend time with people that they had for a short period in their life. They look back and they regret that they didn't spend enough time and just cherish family and friends around them as much as they should have. My dear friend, aim for inner satisfaction and fulfillment. And when you finish your race, when you reach that point, when you're looking back, you will look back with satisfaction and a sense of fulfillment. There's little in this realm that can make a dead man or a dead woman sad. In the same way, when we die to self, we find liberation for our souls. When we die to self, when we pick up our cross, and we die to self, and all these things that the devil can use to affect us, we ultimately find ourselves in a place where we are content, where we are happy, where no matter what the devil can do, he can't pull us down. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying material blessing is bad, but what I'm saying is we should prioritize things. Prioritize the blessings that God has given that are not necessarily quantified in terms of physical wealth. Prioritize the time that you have with God. Prioritize the time that you have with family and friends. Prioritize the time that you have to spend with people around you that are blessings to your life. Prioritize the time that you have alive to make your impact in this realm, and you will go up and you'll enjoy the goodness of God even in the land of the living. This is a message that's not shared so much, but it's a message that should be shared, so that when you reach that stage in life, you will never regret, but you will feel fulfillment. Have you ever asked yourself, surely there must be more than this, in terms of life, in terms of living, in terms of your day-to-day chores and activities that you do? Have you ever asked yourself, there must be more than this? The answer is yes. There is a deeper and more quality life that a believer can live. And that life is only attained when you come to the revelation of the blessings that God has given. Apart from the physical blessings, there are blessings that will make you happy, that will bring joy. But in order to enjoy them, you need to make the conscious decision to prioritize them over and above those things that don't matter as much. Now, I'm not saying the other things don't matter, they do. But what matters the most is your relationship with God, the time that you experience in God's presence, your relationship with your family, your relationship with your friends, the opportunity to live another day, to press on. These are things that are amazing, and if we give them to God and we ask God, help us to enjoy even the things that we overlook, we'll enjoy a life of fulfillment and happiness. Sometimes we take these things for granted and we don't notice what we've got until it's gone, which is why we should appreciate it. And even as we do so, we'll enjoy life to the fullest and we'll be truly blessed. in the essence of what it means to be truly blessed. I'll read that scripture to you one more time, and I want you to think about it, even as we pray. Think about what is being said in this verse. The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 1, from verse 13 to verse 14. And I applied my heart to seek and to search out by wisdom all that is done under the heaven, meaning all that is done on earth. It is an unhappy business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. I have seen everything that is done under the sun, and behold, all is vanity, a striving after the wind. These things make you unhappy if you set them as number one, because they don't have the power to truly satisfy what you are truly searching for on the inside. When you start to recognize and know how to manage the true blessings, you will find true happiness. You will find what it means to be happy even in this realm as you are passing through. This is not our home. We are in this world, but we are not of this world. We are born again of water and of spirit, and we are ambassadors of heaven. So we are passing through. This Christian walk is a walk that we have to walk on our own with the Lord. And it's a spiritual race. It can be likened to a race. It is a journey that, if done well, with the leading of the Holy Spirit, in the confines of the written word of God, you will find that you have true happiness. And the quality of your life will go up. The enjoyment that you have out of life will go to another level. Now, I want to pray with you and for you that even in this time period, you will be truly happy, that you will experience and know what God has given you to the full extent, and that you will appreciate it and enjoy it. In saying that, let us begin to pray. We're going to begin by praising God, and as we discern His presence, then we'll begin to pray, and I trust, know, and believe God is going to bless you. So in saying that, let us begin to praise Him. Father, we just praise You, and we thank You. We thank You for Your goodness. We thank You for Your mercy. We thank You for Your love that never runs out on us. And even today, Your love is present. Your love is with us. You never leave us helpless. We give You praise and thank You that even today, You will make a way where there seems to be no way. And You'll open up the way for us, and we'll press on to greater glories by the power and the grace that is available in Christ to all who believe. Father, we just lift up Your name, and we thank You for miracles, signs, and wonders that You're going to do in my dear friend's life, your dear daughter, my dear friend's life, your dear son. Wherever my dear friend is, distance and time is not a barrier for You. And even today, You will help my dear friend to enjoy true happiness and to appreciate those things that we sometimes overlook. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Hallelujah. My dear friend, a thought that comes to mind right now is, what does it cost you to love your neighbor as you love yourself? Not much, really, in terms of physical money. Although it will take a sacrifice from you. It will take a sacrifice in the way you conduct yourself, in the way you respond when people upset you. But ultimately, if you love your neighbor as you love yourself, and you love all those around you, you fulfill the requirements of the law. You fulfill the requirements in the Bible. Love those around you. Take care of them. Appreciate them. And you will enjoy the goodness and the fullness of the joy that God can give you. Even in the midst of trouble, even in the midst of trying times, even in the midst of pushing on for your dream and pressing on to receive what God has given you, you can enjoy happiness, and you will. Now, as we begin to pray, I want to encourage you to comment down below in the comment section and agree with me. There is so much power in agreement, and even as you comment and agree, God is going to bless you. If you've got any prayer requests and you want us to pray with you and for you, simply go to our website, go to www.gabrielfernandezministries.org. and click on Daily Prayer List. Fill in your prayer request, click Submit. It'll come through to me, and I'm going to trust God with you. But in saying that, let us begin to pray. Father, I pray for my dear friend who's watching this video. Help my dear friend to appreciate all the blessings that You've given my dear friend, especially those things that we sometimes overlook, like the gift of life, the time that we get to spend with You, the time that we get to spend with family, the time that we get to spend with friends. And let my dear friend receive true inner fulfillment and appreciation, knowing that they are living to the fullest as they experience these things. Let my dear friend, your dear son, my dear friend, your dear daughter, receive true fulfillment and happiness in this lifetime. And when it comes to the day that my dear friend shall finish this race, let my dear friend be able to look back and say, wow, thank You, Lord. I feel fulfilled, and I feel like I've done all that you have called me to do, even in this lifetime. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. My dear friend, you are blessed and you cannot be cursed. You are blessed to go up, you are blessed to increase. You are blessed to enjoy the gifts of life that God has given you. The gifts of living another day, the gifts of family, the gifts of friends, the gifts that God has given you, the things that sometimes we take for granted. And may God bless you with physical and material wealth also, so that you can share this with your loved ones. May God give you the grace to love your neighbor as you love yourself. And even going forward, may you be the salt and light in this world, and may God use you mightily. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Until tomorrow, my dear friend, God bless you and goodbye. In saying that, my dear friend, we come to the end of this video. If you are blessed by this video and you feel led to donate or to partner with us to support us in this work that we are doing, then you can do so through PayPal or Patreon. All the links are provided in the description. Until next time, God bless you and goodbye.